Good morning. Great crowd this morning. I'm John Roman. I'm Vice Chair of the Hudson University Board of Trustees, and it's my true honor to welcome all of you here today for this very special event. Today we will announce a major step forward in the evolution of Hudson University. But before we get to that announcement, I'd like to share a few thoughts with you about the important role that the university plays in the lives of our students, our alumni, and our community. The students of Hudson University understand the importance of a college education and the vital role all of us play in helping to make their dreams a reality. Since our founding, this university has dedicated itself to preparing students for successful careers and fulfilling lives. The education experience goes well beyond the classroom, as you all well know. Hudson students are hands-on. They learn by doing. And with an openness to new experiences and different perspectives, they develop into engaged global citizens. As a small university, we're able to bring nimble, flexible approach to higher education that emphasizes innovation, fiscal responsibility, community, and cutting-edge technology. Today, Hudson is on the brink of becoming one of the finest professionally oriented colleges in the United States. We are recognized for excellence in our own state of Maine, but there is growing recognition to the value of our students in neighboring New England and well beyond. For its part, Hudson University has always been an educational leader. Over the course of our 119-year history, the leadership of Hudson University has always vigorously addressed the challenges of the day with one thing in mind, the students. We welcome change that better meets the needs of all of our students, always have, and we always will. Today's announcement is just one example of the kind of initiatives that Hudson University undertakes to transform student lives. Toward this end, we push ourselves to create new facilities and new programs that will allow us to provide higher quality education. Many of us today have connections to the College of Business. Our roots as a business school run very deep. As the educational needs of today's students have changed, we must be willing to revitalize and re-envision our facilities, our technology, and our programs so that students graduate work ready on day one. We continue to go forward, and every day this university is inspiring and preparing students for successful professional careers. Well, today we are on the threshold of a moment in the history of Hudson University. It is a moment that will challenge us to take a big leap forward and commit ourselves to a courageous new vision for the future of our institution. To help articulate this vision, it's my pleasure to introduce Dr. Robert Clark, president of Hudson University. And a couple more comments, Ed. Dr. Clark is Hudson University's sixth president. Since January of 2010, when Dr. Clark first joined the university, he has worked tirelessly to help Hudson University realize its full potential as an educational leader in our region. It's my pleasure to again welcome Bob. Bob and I have served on the, since I've been on the trustees, Bob has come on board as our president, and it's been a real pleasure. Welcome, Bob.
Thank you, John, and I'd like to express my personal appreciation for all of those of you that have joined us today, and they include a wide array of the Hudson community, and I particularly like to mention our partners in the city of Bangor, Kathy Conlow, our city manager, and Mayor Joe Baldacci, and to iterate what wonderful partnerships we've had over these past years with the city, knowing that we are part of a community that delivers educational quality to our students. I'd also like to thank the remainder of our Husson community for joining us here today. This reflects a strong commitment of a team of individuals that have a vision for Husson's future, one that reflects its quality and values in its contribution to Maine's economic future. While I cannot mention every individual by name, and I did start writing down some special individuals, I would like to mention the academic leadership of our College of Business and our university in our Senior Vice President for Academic Affairs, Dr. Lynn Kayogan, and also our College of Business Dean, Dr. Marie Hansen. They certainly have been part of a team that has been instrumental in helping to fulfill concepts, evaluate processes, and envision with me what we might look forward to the future. But the good news is they have not been alone in this process. And so at this time, I would like to ask every member of the audience that is an employee of Husson University to please stand. Certainly, I would express my own personal appreciation for the diligence at which our community has envisioned the teamwork required to arrive at this point in time. A little bit of history: when I first arrived in 2010, I was asked by the Board of Trustees, what do we think for the future of the university? And obviously, as a new president, if you had no thoughts about the future, you shouldn't have been hired in the first place. So we diligently began a process of reviewing what our campus might look like in the future, what our student body might be engaged in the future, what programmatic initiatives we might undertake. And in these times, we had strong foundations laid in the College of Business. But we also had ventures into creating Maine's first graduates in the Doctor of Pharmacy program, transitions to the Doctor of Physical Therapy programs, masters in occupational therapy, nursing programs, also programs in such fields as environmental science, forensic science, legal studies, and we fully integrated the New England School of Communications as a vital element of the university's curricular offerings. We've transformed a School of Science and Humanities to a College of Science and Humanities. All of these initiatives have been undertaken with one focus in mind: the success of our students and their preparation. What we knew is it would take additional resources to bring to fruition these visions. And we set about the process of creating the Shape Our Future campaign. And in that, our trustees embraced a comprehensive capital campaign to raise $21 million to fulfill the needs we have to support students with scholarships and financial support, even as we are one of the most cost-effective private higher education institutions in the state of Maine and, in fact, all of New England. We still know there is much work to be done. We still know that parents, when they open that first bill in July, don't think of us necessarily as a cost-effective value. We know that's part of higher education and the investment that they have trusted to us as Husson University. In this Shaping Our Future campaign this past summer, we began to vision that we would have completed the initial phase one. To date, we have raised just over $20 million to support scholarships and other initiatives. And as I look out over the audience, it's with great appreciation because I know many of you have given and supported these initiatives of the university. And we thank you for that support. But your generosity was an inspiration to us. It inspired us to want to stretch further. And that's where the vision for phase two of a comprehensive capital campaign evolved to move the university forward. What we knew in phase one of the campaign is there was not a great deal of devotion to infrastructure issues, but that we did need, critically, a new College of Business building. We know that the facilities that we have are not adequate to prepare the students for the 21st century challenges in business education. While we have quality programs, and there are many of you that say we have space, because we do. We have a magnificent Peabody Hall, which was in the original academic space of the university from 1968. But just as Chesley Huss envisioned moving the campus from Park Street out to One College Circle in the mid-1960s, because he saw a vision for growth and the importance of that growth to economic future, we needed to act to create an especially attractive learning space for our College of Business, which is in fact the largest College of Business in the state of Maine. So as we look at this concept going forward, and as we continue to meet the needs for future generations, that critical need stood forward, and our trustees affirmed that we would proceed and advance our capital campaign to a goal of $30 million. I would tell you that from a personal basis, we have a critical space need on our campus. And it's because we have been successful. It is because we have met needs in the community and continue to do so. And it is because our student body continues to grow, even at a time when Maine's demographics are not favorable to us in those trends. We need space for growth as the first argument for a College of Business building. Over the last 5 years, enrollments in the College of Business have grown over 30%, and just this past year, they grew at 14%. Think about that in a business context, what it means for the next future here at Husson University. We also know that we need space for other programs. And for those of you that look at this investment as something for the College of Business, I share with you, this is something for the entire university. Because as we transition space in our current locations, these will be available and be redelegated through our academic leadership to other new programmatic issues and new programmatic growth. So the entire university community benefits from a new College of Business building. If growth itself were not the convincing argument for you, we would also share with you things have changed. I was this past week glancing through some 1960s ledgers, and they had big gatherings to discuss the changes in Greg's shorthand. You know, over 200 people in a seminar and a symposium. And I think, you know, back even further than that, we taught such things as seriography. I'm sure we probably don't even know what that is today. And for those of you who want to know, if we teach shorthand today, it's not part of our curricular activities, although some of our students write a lot of crib notes. Appropriate crib notes, excuse me, to make sure I define that appropriately. But we need these new classroom spaces so that students have the advantages of modern, innovative technology. We need innovative space. We envision in the new building a creation of an innovation center, which we will have for the interdisciplinary connections between science, technology, engineering, arts, and mathematics, so we can have the intersections that occur in the business world, real life business interactions happening in a space that is designed for the modern educational pedagogy. We will have a Ronan Center for Financial Technology. We also will have innovations in virtual reality, thanks to last year a $1 million anonymous donation to create the intersection between technology and business applications. We know these are the needs of our students as they prepare for the future. We will connect these facilities to the Richard E. Dyke Center for Family Business because we still believe in today's era that connections to family business are essential for Maine's future. So as we share the needs and we share the opportunities, we're excited today to think what is the vision for that future. And I share with you all of these visions will not be possible without broader community support. And it's not just the immediate Husson family, it is an entire community of learning. We've had gifts to this building idea from as far away as Bahrain and Japan, because our alums that are globally oriented also believe in the value and the quality of the education they've received here at Husson University. We knew in advance that we had a strong community to work together to achieve these goals. So we move this project forward, and we could not be more delighted today than to welcome a significant partnership in the higher education community as we move initiatives forward with the Alfond Foundation. And here today to share with you the connections to this vision from the Harold Alfond Foundation is Greg Powell, chair of their foundation. In addition to leading the foundation, Greg is a chief executive officer and president of Dexter Enterprises Incorporated, where he also serves as a director. In 2005, Harold Alfond appointed Greg to be the chair of the foundation's board of trustees. Greg knew Harold Alfond since childhood, and in 1996, working with Harold, founded Dexter Enterprises Incorporated to continue Harold Alfond's vision for making a difference. The Harold Alfond Foundation furthers his philanthropic legacy. Harold Alfond was the founder of Dexter Shoe Company and a longtime supporter of Maine communities. He ensured that his philanthropy would live on by committing nearly all of his wealth to the foundation, which continues to support charitable causes in the state of Maine. Consistent with Harold Alfond's own giving patterns and philanthropic principles, the foundation helps support education, healthcare, youth development, and other selected charitable causes in Harold's adopted state of Maine. When Greg assumed the leadership, he had an assumption with a passion for what difference could be made by the foundation. And under his leadership, the grants provided by the Harold Alfond have increased sevenfold, and they were budgeted at over $35 million annually in 2004. They have consistently supported the Harold Alfond College Challenge, which provides every child born in the state of Maine with a $500 endowment gift in order to begin the process of how they could vision making a difference and pursuing critically important higher education in Maine. With these thoughts in mind, it is my pleasure to welcome Greg Powell to our stage this morning.
Bob, I think I heard you say you want a new building. Well, thank you, President Clark, for your kind introduction, and my thanks to John Roman, Vice Chairman of the Board, for his warm welcome. On behalf of the Harold Alfond Foundation, I want to thank you all for giving me the chance to share a few thoughts with you this morning about the foundation and to make a special announcement. Husson University and the Harold Alfond Foundation might have more in common than we think. Turns out Chesley Husson, for whom this university is named, was born in Lynn, Massachusetts in 1903. Harold Alfond was born in Lynn, Massachusetts a few years later. Harold grew up in that town where he excelled at sports, playing cards, and gambling. Chesley Husson was said to have excelled at billiards and to have slept on the Lynn YMCA's pool table. It is unknown whether the two ever met, but today at this gathering, we can reflect on their humble origins, how lucky we are that they both moved to Maine, and how each man's dedication to education changed our world for the better. With that history in mind, I'd like to speak about the Foundation's interest in education and the vital role we see education and Husson University playing for our state's economy today and in the years ahead. Following the lifetime giving pattern of Mr. Alfond, the Foundation's grants in education have been based on the belief that a critical mission of education should be to build and sustain a skilled workforce. And the fundamental reality that a skilled workforce is indispensable to economic prosperity. This idea, the correlation between education, quality work, and economic prosperity is not new. And it did not originate from Chesley Husson or Harold Alfond. Over 200 years ago, Ben Franklin extolled the economic mission of education, reminding education scholars that practical skills should be taught above and beyond the usual theology and classical languages. More recently, a Harvard University study has confirmed that educational attainment of our citizens positively impacts family income and economic growth. And on this front, Dr. Anthony Carnevale, a Maine native, Georgetown University economist, and a nationally, if not worldwide, recognized expert on education and the workforce, has described the economic mission of education in these words. The inescapable reality is that ours is a society based on work. Hence, if secondary and post-secondary educators cannot fulfill their economic mission to help grow the economy by preparing youths and adults to become successful workers, then they also will fail in their cultural and political mission to create good neighbors, good citizens, and lifelong learners. Increasing the economic relevance of education should, if done properly, extend the ability of educators to empower Americans to work in the world rather than retreat from it. At the Foundation, we are persuaded by Dr. Carnevale's description of the economic mission of education. We live in a global economy, more competitive than ever, where the skill of our workforce is continually tested. We believe that the skill and education of our workforce, nationally and in Maine, will determine our future leadership role in the world. So at the Foundation, we see extraordinary challenges today that make the need for a renewed and creative commitment to the economic mission of education more compelling than at any time in our history. I'd like to share with you three challenges that the Foundation is currently focused on. First, not enough of our citizens go on to higher education and complete it. Today, only one-third of Maine's population have higher education degrees, and only 40% of graduating high school students apply for and complete associate or bachelor's degrees, according to studies done by the Mitchell Institute and the Compact for Higher Education. Yet by 2018, just next year, over 60% of future jobs in Maine will require higher education in some form. Our second concern is this. Here in Maine, our skilled workforce is declining. Between 2014 and 15, for example, 14,000 skilled workers left the state. Meanwhile, our population is aging and our birth rate has not been rising. Third, with the exception of a little university in Bangor, Maine, there has been inadequate alignment and interaction between higher education and employers, such that the skilled workforce needed by Maine employers and those employers who may wish to locate in Maine is not present. Well, I'll share a little history with you. A little over 15 years ago, Harold Alfond and I visited this handsome campus. Back then, the university had one campus, just over 1,800 students, 44 full-time faculty, 10 buildings, 2 athletic fields, and assets of only $27 million. And your baseball field needed a boost. But while many other academic institutions awaited the epiphany that a critical mission of higher education should be to equip students with the knowledge and skills necessary to get and keep good jobs, Husson University had that all figured out. Husson was well on its way to becoming a leader in educating job-ready students. Today, 15 years later, Husson has multiple campuses throughout the state, over 3,500 students, triple the full-time faculty, 16 buildings, double the outdoor fields and athletic facilities, and over $100 million in assets. Since 2002, over $73 million has been invested by Husson in infrastructure alone. Most importantly, though, Husson is a vital contributor to sustaining and growing our state's economy and to increasing the supply of workers with higher education required for today's jobs. Husson's programs of study and internship program would have pleased Ben Franklin, as they emphasize a hands-on, experiential education, an education which connects theory to the realities of workforce needs of our state's employers. And today, especially in business education, Husson is a leader. Consider these facts. Husson has the largest college of business in the state with over 1,400 students. Enrollment of students in the business program has grown 32% over the past 5 years. Husson's business education is accessible from Presque Isle to Wells and beyond. Over 75% of Husson business graduates stay and work in Maine. And they work at great companies, Jackson Labs, Unum, Bangor Savings Bank, Mimic, Acadia Insurance, just to name a few. And these employers and others say Husson graduates are as well prepared as they come. 94% of Husson graduates are employed or in graduate school 1 year after graduation. And finally, and believe us all, there are many more, the university has tempered tuition increases and welcomed low-income and first-generation college students. Husson is all of these great things and more. Just ask President Clark, and he'll give you an earful. And before you know it, you'll be writing a check, too. But at the foundation, we didn't just take President Clark's word for the value of the Husson University and its contributions to the state and the lives of its students. Husson students have told us. Since Mr. Alfond's first grant to Husson over 15 years ago, and the university's establishment of a scholarship fund in his name, countless letters and notes have been sent our way from Husson students, notes of thanks, hopes, and dreams. One student wrote, "Dear Mr. Alfond, I am a single mother whose opportunity to return to school depended entirely on your gift. As I study to build my career, I give you my promise that my education will not be taken for granted. Because of your scholarship, I can continue to work towards my goal, and this means the world to my daughter and me." Another student wrote, "I currently attend Husson University as a declared accounting major. I plan on going for my CPA in the 5-year program. I come from Aetna, south of Bangor. I want to work for a major accounting firm. Your scholarship has been a blessing. It has inspired me to work harder and to try my best. Thanks to your generosity, I am able to afford going to college here at Husson and fulfill my life dream." And there are many more letters like this, some of which I have brought with me this morning. So there you have it, folks. Aspiring students from all walks of life, a great little university with the state's largest college of business, outstanding leadership, strong community partnerships, and all of this producing quality, job-ready graduates who choose to live and work here in Maine, a state that desperately needs to grow its skilled workforce, to grow its economy. There's only one problem. Husson's College of Business, Maine's largest business school, is without a dedicated building for business education. Now, if Harold Alfond and Chesley Husson were with us today, they would be thinking, as your leadership has, that it's time the state's largest and fastest growing business school had a new state-of-the-art building. So in their honor, and on behalf of the Harold Alfond Foundation, I am pleased to announce our grant to Husson University for construction of that building in the amount of $4 million. There comes a time in every speaker's life when he looks out over his audience and sees faces exuding nothing but unalloyed pleasure and joy, and it's usually after the words, "in conclusion." So, in conclusion, let me leave you with this. There's a catch. There's a catch with this grant. Harold Alfond loved to say, "Don't tell me, show me." He believed in teamwork. And during his lifetime of giving, as it is today with his foundation, he would want to challenge the Husson community to come together as a team, to get a shovel in the ground, and get this much-needed building up and running ASAP. With that in mind, our grant of $4 million is a challenge grant. For every $2 donated to the university for this building by you and other Husson supporters, the Alfond Foundation will donate a dollar. So next time you see President Clark coming your way, remember Harold Alfond and Chesley Husson, Chief as they called him, the card games and pool table of Lynn, Massachusetts. Remember both men moved to Maine and what both men did for education in Maine, then get out your checkbook and join the team. And remember that Husson graduates are job ready. They stay and work in our great state. So when we invest in Husson University, we are investing in this great state and its future. Thank you very much.
We shared the importance this has for Husson and the challenge I accept on behalf of the entire Husson community, the challenge that is put before us by the Alfond Foundation, because we all believe in the criticality of higher education and its important role here in the state of Maine. On behalf of the university and in recognition of this commitment by the Harold Alfond Foundation to providing the university with the largest single gift in the university's history, it is my pleasure this 7th day of April and I'm not even reading a script, you know, that we can provide this link for our past with a recognition of a Forest Heart eagle that soars for the university.
We can take it back over to the table. And then
I feel like I should be getting my pool cue out here. Person that's very familiar to us, U.S. Senator Susan Collins, is no stranger to Hudson University. From 1994 to 1996, she was the director of the Richard Dyke Center for Family Business, right here on the Bangor campus. Senator Collins was also awarded an honorary doctorate from Hudson in 1997 in recognition of her service to not only the university, but to our community. While Susan was planning on joining us for today, the Senate, as you well know, is still in session. And as many of you know, Senator Collins has never missed a vote in the Senate. While we wish she could have joined us today, we understand that the business of the community of the country sometimes takes precedence. Despite her very busy schedule, Senator Collins thoughtfully recorded her thoughts on a video so that we could share them with you today. Here's a message from Senator Susan Collins.
Good morning. If you're watching this video rather than talking with me in person, it's because the Senate is voting today. And as much as I long to be with you, I've never missed a vote in my time serving Maine in the United States Senate. But what a great day this is for Hudson University and our state of Maine. Today we celebrate the inspiring legacy of an outstanding Maine business leader and philanthropist. Throughout his life, Harold Alfond was devoted to the well-being of our state and our people. From healthcare to sports to education, Harold's spirit of giving has touched so many Mainers. This marvelous gift from his foundation to Maine's largest college of business will help to create new opportunities, future jobs, and more prosperity. We also celebrate another great tradition. From its start more than a century ago, Hudson University has been a school guided by an entrepreneurial spirit and a commitment to educating students of limited means. Hudson has grown tremendously, both in the size of its beautiful campus and in the range of courses and degrees it offers. It has grown because throughout all those years, Hudson has remained true to its founding principles. It continues to deliver real value through hands-on education. This celebration provides an invaluable lesson to the students here today. Success that you achieve, the kind of success that Harold achieved, and the kind that a Hudson education puts within your reach offers you the greatest opportunity of all. And that is the opportunity to give back to your community, your school, and your state, all of which has helped to make your success possible. As the first executive director of the Dyke Center for Family Business, I am so proud to be a member of the extended Hudson University family. This significant act of generosity by the Harold Alfond Foundation and the confidence it demonstrates in Hudson makes me even prouder of that family and of our great state of Maine. Congratulations and have a wonderful celebration.
Thank you, Senator Susan Collins. And if you are watching this event on our video stream, please know we value your support and you'll always be a treasured member of our Hudson University family. We'd like to conclude today's events with two more very brief videos. The next video you'll see will be a physical presentation of the new College of Business building, followed by a video you'll hear from our Hudson University students. At the conclusion of these videos, please join us in the Darling Atrium for refreshments as we celebrate this major milestone for Hudson University.
Thank you to the Harold Alfond Foundation.
Thank you for investing in the future of Hudson University.
Thank you.
Thank you for your generous gift.
Thank you for investing in our future.
Thank you for your generous gift that will help shape the future for Hudson University.
Thank you.
Thank you for your gift.
Thank you for your support and generosity.
Thank you for your generous gift.
As a current student, I'm eager to see how this generous gift is going to shape the future of our university.
Thank you to the Harold Alfond Foundation for your support.